Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Amber Glacé. Glacé is just a glossy finish that you might put over the top of something that's frozen. So we're going to start with a large pot here, and into that we're putting 1/2 cup of white sugar, 1/2 cup of light brown sugar, firmly packed, and 1/2 cup of orange juice. The amber in the name refers to the color that this is going to turn out to be. But I'll stir this around, then I'm going to take it to the stove and bring it to a boil over medium heat. Then I need to turn it down to the lowest setting and let it boil for 10 minutes while I'm stirring it constantly. And this is the type of thing that will bubble up, so you really need to use the lowest heat. But we'll start with medium to bring it to a boil. This is what your glacé looks like near the end of cooking. So you can see it's bubbling all over, but very gently. And that way you don't have it climbing up the edges of the pot. So I'm going to bring this over to my workspace, and then I'm going to let it cool. So we won't really be working with it again until it's cool. Here is our cooled amber glacé. And you can see the color. It's nice and amber looking, and it has a little bit of warmth to it. Sometimes when you check it, you'll notice that it's beginning to set up a little bit. There might be some sugar around the edges. And if you let it go for a long time, if you have cooked it to the maximum, then it might set up. So we don't want that happening, so we're going to go ahead while it's nice and workable. We're going to place it in a little pitcher. Now, I did measure this on a thermometer, a readout thermometer, and it got to 220 degrees. So that will give you an idea of where you're headed with your amber glacé. I'm going to assemble this dessert in a little sherbet dish, and I've got 2 scoops of ice cream in here. I plan to put another one in, so I've just waited for you so that you could see the third one going in. Any brand of ice cream that you want. I have something that's supposedly low carb, carb smart, but use whatever you want. Vanilla is a good flavor though to go with this amber glacé. So when you have your amber glacé in your little pitcher, you can pour it if it's still pourable. If it's thickened up like mine, then you'll have to spoon it. And then we're not quite finished with it. What we're going to do is put some peanut brittle on the top. Now this peanut brittle was some that was bought from the grocery store already made. And I would rather have homemade, but I didn't want to stop and take the time to do that. I do have a recipe for peanut brittle in Betty's Kitchen. If you'd like to look that up and take the time to make it before you do this, then that would be wonderful. But this needs to be crushed up. So I started by putting about 1/2 cup, a little more than 1/2 cup, in a plastic bag. And I just beat it a few times with a rolling pin so that would crush it up. And then I put it in a kitchen chopper and got it chopped so that it's like this. Parts of it are fine and parts of it are chunky. So just take a spoon and get some of both of those and then go to the top and let this come down the sides. And then to top it off, I'm going to put some fresh mint that came from the garden just about 5 minutes ago. So we'll just put 1 sprig in and save the other one for another dish. Now I wanted to show you that I have on my counter some flowers that have just come into bloom. These are daylilies. Now some of you have asked me to give a tour of my flower garden. Actually, I don't have a flower garden. We just have plantings around the house. So they're all around the house, and at different times they will come into bloom. The star of the show today is the amber glacé. So I want to take a bite of it, and I'll be getting some peanut brittle along with vanilla ice cream, but I think I can tell you what the amber glacé is like. So here's what a bite looks like. Very crunchy, that being the peanut brittle. And obviously I can taste the ice cream. but there's just a hint of citrus that comes from the orange juice and the amber glacé, and also the brown sugar really flavors it, so it's like candy. It's like some kind of a part of a Snickers bar or something like that. Tastes really good. It's something that is very cooling in the summertime, and I have been making a few things like that so that you would be able to have treats to go to that are new to you, but they will cool you off. Hope you enjoy this.